everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Lilbumblebear's Let's Play. I'm Chris and Lilbumblebear, and I am back with Sesame Street numbers. I did letters in the previous Sesame Street episode. I have a playlist in the description box. Go check out all the videos. Be sure to give the video a like, leave a comment down below if you remember playing this in the 90s, and subscribe for more nostalgic content. I'm a Twitch streamer. Go check out my channel. Catch me live. Say hi. I've got social media, and I have a Discord if you'd be interested in being in my community server. Please post down below.
Elmo had a great idea.
And we'll get started.
It's time to look for sparkles. Sparkles, sparkles, sparkles. Sparkles, sparkles, sparkles.
All right, Elmo.
Who's far down street? When you see sparkles, press button.
We'll start all the way on one side and work our way over.
Seven.
Two. Three. Four.
Greetings, my little one. Welcome to my castle.
Ooh, let's look around. Let's see. Oh, there's a book. Let's read it.
Count Goldilocks and the Three Bears. Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived in a forest.
Oh, look at the bees.
Bear, Papa Bear and Baby Bear. These three bears were perfectly happy with their lives together. No one bothered the three bears or asked them any silly questions. The bear family was very thankful for this. But then one day, they decided to have a picnic lunch. So Papa Bear made some honey sandwiches for their outing. Just as they were about to leave the house, who do you think showed up? That's right. Count Goldilocks. Count Goldilocks was a boy who had so many golden curls, even he couldn't count them, although he tried. As soon as he saw the three bears, he said,
"Aha! Look! That's one furry bear! That's two furry bears! And there! That's three brown furry bears!"
Papa Bear turned to Mama Bear and asked,
"Do you know this guy?"
"I've never seen him before in my life," Mama Bear answered. Then Baby Bear added,
"Aren't we going on our picnic?"
"Picnic? I love picnics,"
Count Goldilocks exclaimed.
"And look, you all have picnic baskets. That's one picnic basket. That's two picnic baskets. That's three wonderful baskets. Why do you have three picnic baskets?"
"Look," Papa Bear said, "you're right. We do have three picnic baskets, and we are three bears, but we're on our way out, so if you wouldn't mind..."
But then Count Goldilocks saw the three bears, three chairs. He was so excited he couldn't help himself.
"That's one chair,"
Count Goldilocks exclaimed.
"That's two chairs. That's three wonderful wooden chairs. Why do you have three wooden chairs?"
By now, the three bears were getting mad. They were also very hungry. because it was way past their lunchtime. They didn't know what to do.
Oh, look!
Count Goldilocks said.
How cute! That's one bear bed. That's two bear beds. That's three bear beds. Why do you have three bear beds?
The bears looked at each other and didn't know what to say. Suddenly, Baby Bear shouted.
I get it. We have three picnic baskets, and we have three wooden chairs, and we have three bear beds. They all come in threes because there are three of us. We are the three bears. Wow!
Papa Bear and Mama Bear had to agree. Of course, they were very pleased that Baby Bear had answered Count Goldilocks' question, but more importantly, they were delighted to be able to get on with their lunch. The end.
You're listening to W357, the odd station.
Okay, come on. All right, over this way.
Here we are, guys.
This the stuff
like
is all back.
Oh, that's my shoe.
Oh, yes.
Oh, thank you. All right, you ready? Okay. Here we go.
First was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family.
Each likes the other, sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
First was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family. Each likes the other,
sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
And the dog came later on.
Oh, yeah, I remember Elmo.
And so did the cat. And the goldfish.
And the turtle and the frog.
And the car. Don't forget about that.
Until and then we moved and we sold it.
First was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family.
Each likes the other, sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
We agree. We're really a perfectly ordinary, ordinarily perfect family.
First
was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family.
Each likes the other, sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
Okay, hold on. Real quick.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Here
we
go. You ready? You first.
First was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family. Each likes the other.
Sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
The dog came later on.
And so did the cat.
And the goldfish.
And the turtle.
And the frog.
And the car.
Until we moved and we sold it. First was me.
Then was we.
Then was them.
That made all of us.
And we're a family. A family. A family.
Each likes the other, sister.
Brother.
Father.
Mother.
We agree. We're really a perfectly ordinary, ordinarily perfect. A perfectly ordinary, ordinarily perfect. A perfectly ordinary, ordinarily perfect family.
Wait a second.
Oh,
no. Uh-oh.
Something.
Oh, hey, what happened?
That was a cool song.
Headlines on the hour with Kermit the Frog.
Ooh,
scientists
Kermit.
Have proven that little girls are not just made of sugar and spice and everything nice. A spokeswoman said that while little girls are frequently nice, there's a lot more to them than just that.
Okay. Thanks, Kermit.
At that.
Ooh, let's call
One,
them.
1, 2, 3, 4 wonderful friends. You can call.
Hi there, this is Ernie, and you've just reached the Bert and Ernie joke line. Here's a joke. What did the flower say to the bee? Buzz off. Pretty funny, huh? Call back again for some more great jokes. Here's laughing with you. Bye-bye. Hi there, this is Ernie, and you...
Wait a second, I was trying to call Bert. Oh, maybe I don't get to call Bert. Okay.
Hi, you've reached Big Bird's number hotline. Today's number is 6. That's right, 6 is today's hot number. So if anyone asks you how much 3 plus 3 is, tell them 6. That's sure to impress them. Bye for now.
All right. Note to self. Impress people by telling them 3 plus 3 is 6. Got it. Thank you, Big Bird.
Hello?
Oh, Elmo.
Oh, hi.
You look so
Elmo,
tired.
I'm so glad you called. Elmo loved to talk on the telephone.
Are you getting enough sleep, Elmo?
What should we talk about? Oh, Elmo have no idea what to talk about. Call Elmo back again and see if Elmo thinks of something. Bye-bye.
Department store, elevator going down.
A kitty and a cat with mittens brand new got into an elevator.
Top floor.
Then there were two.
One, two.
Two little animals feeling carefree. A pool came from market. Then there were three.
One, two, three.
Three little animals waiting to arrive. In came a mule and a mare. And then there were five.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five little animals acting sedate. The doggy family joined them. And then there were eight.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Eight little animals standing in a line. Shep the sheep sauntered in. And then there were nine.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Nine little animals waiting yet again. Mr. Hall got them. And then there were ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Ten little animals, rides all done. Left the elevator empty.
Ground floor.
Then there were none.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. 11 o'clock, time to get up. It's a lovely 11 morning. I heard 11 worms yawning. I saw 11 cows sleeping midst the buttercups. I said, how's your cottage cheese? And they said,
a dryer. Oh,
11 pretty birdies in the trees. Bright yellow beaks and pinky knees. 11 chicks hatching, 11 cats scratching. 11's the number for me. 11 ducklings quacking. 11 pigs lip smacking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
One, two, three.
Greetings, my little friends. It's time to play. I've got your number. All right, my beautiful bats. Go and hide behind one of these lovely numbers. Abracadabra. The bats are now hiding behind a number. Listen to the clue. My little friend Elmo went looking for butterflies. In the morning, he saw one butterfly. Then, in the afternoon, he didn't see any butterflies at all. How many butterflies did Elmo see altogether? Hooray for you! You found my bats. You are right. My bats were hiding behind the wonderful number one. Elmo saw one butterfly.
Tremendous! Stupendous! Let's play again this! Ha ha ha!
All right, my beautiful bats. Go and hide behind one of these lovely numbers. Abracadabra! The bats are now hiding behind a number. Listen to the clue. Big Bird was watching four butterflies. Oscar scared one of them away. How many butterflies were left? Oh, are we finished playing? Well, that is too bad. What a delightful time we had. I am counting on you to visit my castle again soon.
Greetings, little one. That was hello, we say. I'm a little one, too. Greetings mean hello. To give Elmo a present. Elmo wants five things in his present. Move star to something to give to Elmo. Then press the button. To give Elmo a present, put the star on the lid and press the button. Yay! Now Elmo gets to open his present. A top. One. A hydrant. Two. A vegetable. Three. A swing. Four. A duck. Five. That's five things. Good! You gave Elmo 5 things! You sure know a lot about numbers! Ooh, Elmo loved that present! Let's do another one! Elmo wants 2 things in his present. Okay, Elmo ready to start playing too. But Elmo wants to play again real soon. Oh, you go visit Bert and Ernie. Elmo will miss you. And don't forget to visit Elmo later. Bye.
Hey, Bert, look who's here.
Oh, hi.
Ernie and the Count and the 3 Little Pigs. Once upon a time, not so long ago, Ernie met the 3 little pigs. You know, the ones who went through that whole terrible ordeal with the big bad wolf. Well, Ernie and the pigs became such good friends that the pigs invited Ernie to come by and visit them. So one day, Ernie decided to surprise his friends with a visit. On his way to their house, he saw the Count, who was standing by the road, counting the passers-by.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ernie, where are you going?
The Count asked.
I'm going to visit my good friends, the 3 little pigs,
Ernie answered.
The 3 little pigs? I have always wanted to count them,
the Count said, getting very excited.
Can I go too?
Ernie didn't want to be impolite, so he invited the Count to come along. When they reached the 3 little pigs' house, Ernie knocked on the door.
That's 1 knock,
the Count said as Ernie knocked on the door for the first time.
That's 2 knocks,
the Count said as Ernie knocked on the door for the second time. Ernie was about to ask the Count to stop counting when suddenly the door opened. Standing in a row were the 3 little pigs. They were very happy to see Ernie. But before they could say a word, the Count spoke up.
That's 1 pig,
the Count said.
That's 2 pigs.
Who's this guy? One of the pigs asked.
Oh, he's a friend,
Ernie responded.
That's 3 little pigs,
the Count continued. Well, why is he counting us? Another pig asked.
Oh, he loves to count,
Ernie replied.
Counting is my life,
the Count added. Well, I hate being counted, the 3rd pig said out loud, and the other pigs squealed in agreement.
Well, I don't want to bother you,
Ernie said and started to leave.
Oh, don't get us wrong. We're glad you came to visit, the 1st pig said. In fact, this is a great time for you to come because we were just starting our annual family reunion.
Oh no, you don't mean that all your pig relatives are here?
Ernie asked. Of course, one of the pigs said as he opened the door a little further to reveal a whole room full of little pigs.
Look, Ernie!
The Count exclaimed.
I am so happy! Look at all the little pigs!
Count, please don't. Please, Count.
That's 1 little pig,
the Count began, ignoring Ernie's pleas.
That's 2 little pigs,
he continued. In moments, the Count was in the center of the room, surrounded by pigs.
Oh, well,
Ernie said, still standing outside the door.
Gee. Maybe I'll go visit the 4 and 20 blackbirds and see what's cooking with them.
The end.
Ah!
You cats heard of harmony?
Harmony? What's that?
What's he talking about? Harmony's like cooperation, playing together. Now look, you on the tub, lay down a nice easy beat. That's it. Now Jug, get in there and join him. Oh, that's real cool. Banjo, give him the melody. Crazy. Okay, Comb, you help out too. That's what I call harmony.
It's what I call cooperation.
Tired of looking everywhere, day after day, for the number you need the most? Now, for the first time ever, numbers in a box. One convenient, easy-to-use package with all the numbers from 0 to 9. These basic digits are the only ones you'll ever need. Look at all the fabulous numbers you get. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9.
I've got an idea. Let's read a story. What do you say?
Great! You want to play the paperclip chase with me and Bert?
Oh, yeah! Paperclips? Oh, boy, Ernie, I have a really interesting paperclip collection.
Exactly, Bert. Now, I have hidden your paperclip collection all over our room.
What?
Now, all you have to do is find them.
Oh, no, my paperclips? Ernie, where did you put them? Oh, I'm no good at games.
Well, it looks like old buddy Bert needs your help to find as many of his paperclips as you can.
I'll say.
Now, here's what you do. You have 3 chances to find as many paperclips as possible.
Okay.
I hid 1 paperclip behind everything that's blue.
Oh, so the book?
The storybook. It's blue, and that means you get 1 paperclip. Way to go.
Okay. How about...
It's time to try another place where you think you might find his paperclips.
I
hid 1 paperclip behind everything that's blue. The airplane! It's blue, so you get 1 paperclip. Good going. And now you have 1 last chance to find Bert's paperclips. Go ahead and choose another place to look. I hid 1 paperclip behind everything that's blue. The roller skates! It's blue, and that means you get 1 paperclip. Way to go! Well, that's it. That was your 3rd try. How'd we do, Bert? 3 paperclips. Good going.
Oh, thanks a lot. Aren't they beautiful, Ernie?
Well, yeah.
Oh, boy. I can't wait to make them into a chain.
Next time, I'll have to hide Bert's paperclips in harder places.
What was that?
Nothing, Bert.
Ernie.
You have 3. I hid paperclips behind everything that's alive, and everything that swims, and everything that's yellow. What? You're ready to stop? Well, sure. We can do that. We'll find Bert's paperclip some other time.
But Ernie, my paperclips.
Don't worry, Bert. We can play again later.
Bye-bye now. That sure was fun.
Yeah, come back anytime, and maybe I'll show you my bottle cap collection.
Ooh. Oh! Elmo, not see you come back. Who did you visit? Elmo, no Big Bird will be happy to see you. Elmo, play with you later, okay? Bye-bye.
Hi! I'm so happy you came to visit my nest.
Hey, Big Bird.
Little Miss Muffet Bird.
I love these stories.
Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet, eating her curds and birdseed. Then from above her, a grouch came to hover and said, "What's to drink? I'm thirsty." So Little Miss Muffet got up from her tuffet and opened the pantry door. There's some cheese and a cake, a pie and some steak, but nothing to drink anymore.
"It's hard to think when there's nothing to drink,"
said the grouch with a wink of his eye.
"I don't think I can wait, or I'm sure to be late, so I'll take the cheese and the pie."
Before she could speak, her beak had a tweak, and she let loose a terrible sneeze. When the air had cleared, just as she feared, the grouch was all covered with cheese.
The end.
Alarm clock rang. The bell woke me up as quick as anything. I sure am glad the bell woke me up that way, 'cause otherwise I might have stayed asleep all day. Oh, the bells, listen to the bells. Ding-a-ling, hear them ring, everybody listen to the bells. With my brother, heard the telephone. It went ring, ring, a ding, it wouldn't leave us alone. The bell made me answer, and I said, "Hello." It was Grandma wanna take me to the picture show. Oh, the bells, listen to the bells. I spent the day at school until the final bell. It said the school day was over and the week as well. If that bell hadn't rung, what were we to do? We might have stayed in school all night and all the weekend too. Oh, the bell. Listen to the bell. The doorbell rang. Who could it be? It was Grandma, and she brought a present just for me. If we hadn't heard the doorbell, then how sad for all, 'cause Grandma'd still be standing out there in the hall. Oh, the bell. Listen to the bell.
Alarm clock bell, telephone bell, school bell.
Dorothy Frog here with today's traffic report. Today, in a freak accident on the Fairyland Freeway, a van driven by the three bears collided with a limousine carrying the three little pigs. Nobody was harmed. An entirely new fairy tale is being written.
Oh, that's funny.
Now, for the first time, Number Records brings you Zero's Greatest Hits. That's right. Order now and in no time get these great hits. Nothing matters. It's nothing, and nothing plus nothing makes nothing. Not to mention that wild new dance craze, doing nothing. Call right now and as a special bonus, get that wild new number one more time. Hurry, we may not have any left.
I love their advertising.
Hello, bird.
Oh, boy. Today is your lucky day. It's time to play my near and far game. When you weren't looking, I hid my bag of birdseed behind something in my nest. And if you find the birdseed, you win the game. It's easy to play. Just move around my nest, and I'll tell you if you're getting nearer to the birdseed or farther away. When you think you know where my birdseed is, move the star to the hiding place and press the button. Okay. Now, start looking. It's hiding near the phone. You're very near the birdseed. It's hiding near the bubbles.
There it is.
Yippee! My birdseed. It was behind my teddy bear all the time. You win.
That's my cameo.
You win. You found the hiding place. And there's my birdseed. There's another one out there. Go find it. Try looking near the bubbles. You're kind of near the birdseed. It's hiding near the bubbles. Yippee! My birdseed! It was behind the television all the time. You win! You win! You found the hiding place. And there's my birdseed. Let's play again. It's hidden near the bear. You're very near the birdseed. Try looking near the television. Yippee! My birdseed. It was behind my bubble pipe all the time. You win! You win! You found the hiding place. And there's my birdseed. You're so good at finding birdseed, I've made this one a little tougher. Oh, you're ready to stop playing? Okay, you can come back and play my near and far game whenever you want. Goodbye, I'll miss you. Come back and visit my nest again soon.
Play with Big Bird.
Well, guys, that about wraps up this little episode of Sesame Street. I hope you enjoy. Make sure to check out the playlist in the description box for other Sesame Street games I've done. leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe. Thank you so much to all the people that enjoy my content and are here and enjoying these videos and telling me that I help you remember your childhood. It means a lot to me, and that's why I love doing these videos. Remember, you are special and loved, you are never alone, and you're always welcome to come hang out anytime. Until next time, guys, God bless, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye, everyone.
Is it time for Elmo to say goodbye? Press the button again to leave Sesame Street. Elmo ready to stop now, too. Elmo had good time playing with you.